Hello YouTube, this is Prash. This is my first tutorial video for my brand new channel called ExAccounting. I'll be doing a brief intro and trailer for the channel and what it's all about later, and you can check out their later stage. But today I'll be making a very short and quick solution to rounding off your numbers. So if you're working in a multinational company where you have to deal with multiple currencies and your home currency and your reporting currency might be different, in that case you might have to produce reports and summaries and tables, your financial tables, in various other formats. So for example, this summary I have prepared here as a sample. Your home currency is in Australian dollar and your reporting currency is US dollars, and you also have to produce your report in round off in thousands. So this is complete figures, whole figure, and this is in thousands. So this is thousands USD or total exchange rate, and then divide by 1,000, and then you have to report for your upper management or executive management whenever they need. Now it's easy to just, you can go and put a round up formula here, or you can put round off here like this. And you can round it up to 2 decimal or 1 decimal or 0 decimal, and you can do like this. But if there you have multiple numbers and you are frequently producing this kind of reports and you have to round off, it will be very tedious and it might create an error. So for that I could be able to figure out a VBA code which you can put in your ribbons here, and you can use it by just selecting it and just click that particular function, UDF function more or like, and you just round off all the numbers. I'll show you exactly how to do that, just bear with me for a while. So I will just close this, we don't have to save it. I'll just open a new Excel workbook. There are multiple ways to do this, to save this macro and use it as at your will, but this is the most easiest way I found in my work style, and I'm sure you will find easier as well, but it's up to you how you can do it. But this method will be creating a Excel add-in, and then we can save it in add-in profile and activate the add-in. First of all, you need to activate your developer tab, which you can go to options and go to customize ribbon and activate this developer tab, which is by default it will be untick. You just have to tick and click OK, so you'll have it. Now we'll be going to Visual Basic. I'll be starting with the new VBA project with the same book which we are working right now. Just right click and you can just insert a module. You just open it up and we'll copy this code. So I don't know, I wouldn't be lying to you if I know everything about this code, but this code I have worked around based on already formatted code, for which was for the wrapping of error, wrapping of your formula with if error. So it's the same concept, but instead of round off, you'll be wrapping up with if error. That tutorial I'll be doing separately in another video, so look out for that. But I could able to do a workaround based on that particular code to a round off formula, which is always I was looking for, and I was able to successfully do it. So you just have to use this code. I'll leave this code in the link to this code in the description below for you to find, for you to just copy it. So this is a ready-made code. You just have to paste it in your workbook which you're going to create as Excel add-in. So this code is ready and all the description is there and it's just ready to go. You just save it, and this workbook we have to save as Excel add-in. So select as Excel add-in. It will save in the default Excel add-in folder, which is the correct folder. We'll just name it wrap up roundup. Okay, now we have to go to that particular folder which is in app data. Or the better way would be to open an Excel sheet and try to save is at add-in. If you go to add-in, you'll get the exact address. Just copy that address and put in your search bar. So this file, we saved it in this particular location, which is users your name, app data, roaming, Microsoft, and Addin. Then you just have to click, double click on this file, and enable macros. That's all you have to do. And I'll try again just to be sure. Enable macros. Once it's done, you don't have to save it. Just open a new file, just any blank Excel workbook. Go to developers, Excel add-in. This is MS Office 2016, so this is Excel 2016. But I'm sure that it would be same in other formats like 2010 and 2013 as well. So you just have to choose your add-in which you created, which is wrap-up, roundup, which is the name we've given, and click OK. Now the add-in is not activated automatically. We have to create add-in and put it in the ribbon. So that I will show you how to create a custom ribbon bar just like this ones. We'll be making one more at the end. After power pivot, we'll be creating an additional macros tab where we'll put our customized function we created. So we'll go to options and customize ribbon. And we'll be creating a new tab. And this is already created, the new group. Here we have to move in our add-in which we created. Now we'll just have to rename it. It's up to you what name you want. So I'll just keep it macros. And I'll have to find where the macros are. I mean, where the add-ins, which is, of course, it's a macro. So you have to choose macros. And you have to choose whatever you created. So even though we name the Excel add-in as wrap-up, roundup, but the name of the formula, the name of the function which we created, the macro's name is roundup cells, the sub macro name. So that we have to add here, and you can even modify this, rename and choose the limited option here. There is no customization option. I'll choose this grid, click OK. So now if you see, this roundup is created, and this is a very good function. If I go through here, basically what this roundup function does, roundup cell VBA code does, is first of all, it checks whether for a particular selection, wherever you select, has a formula or not. So if I right now, this sheet does not have anything. So if I choose everything and try to run it, it'll say there were no formula found in your system. This is a very smart function, very smart VBA code, I should say. And it first checks whether you have a formula anywhere to round up or not. So it doesn't harm your other data in any way, or doesn't screw up your work at all. So then if it founds any formula to round up, it round ups itself and it closes. I mean, it ends there. So it does nothing to your workbook or your work at all. So don't worry about it. I have tried it. I'm using it my work all the time, and it hasn't caused me any serious issue, any sort of issue at all. So now we'll open our sample file. Now these numbers, I already put data. This is as I told you before, this is the Australian dollars in the whole number. This is the sale, cost of sales, and the number which I want to convert to US dollar and also in thousands are in yellow. So these are the manual entries. There are no formulas there. So these are the only this formula I put. Of course, you have to put this formula manually because you have to apply your exchange rate. So US dollar exchange rate is one Australian dollar is equal to 0.72 as on today. So I will multiply with that particular by creating a formula where I will choose absolute reference, which is like this, and divide by 1000, because I want to divide this whole number by 1000. I want to report these numbers in thousands. So that's what I did, and I only did for this yellow colored rows and cells which are manual. This gross profit, GP, net profit, and net profit percentage are automatic. It follows the same formula and structure. So I want to select this, and I want to round them off. So I just have to click here and it's done. So if you go here, all the cells, which we try to round off has been rounded off properly. You can select them, you can go to home and adjust the look of the decimal if you want to show or not, because we rounded off to zero as the function rounds up to zero automatically, which also you can add it here. You can do 1, 2, or 3 anywhere. Wherever there is zero, here only one place you have to round, make it your decimal of your desire. So if you want 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you can do it here. So that's all, folks. Thank you very much for joining me. This was my first ever Excel tutorial, and I'm really excited with this channel. So if I made some mistake somewhere, let me know in the talk. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I'll be happy to help you with that. I'll be making one more tutorial, also the channel trailer, as I said before, and I'll be making one more VBA code tutorial for wrapping up your formula with if error, which is quite useful if you're doing a very complex calculation. So look out for that, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.